Welcome to Dr. Martin, Head and Neck Radiology. I'm Dr. Martin, and today we will explore a fascinating and often incidental finding in nasopharyngeal imaging, the Tornwaldt cyst. Although benign and usually asymptomatic, recognizing it is important to avoid misdiagnosis or unnecessary concern. Let's delve into the imaging features, clinical relevance, and differential diagnosis of this not-so-rare entity. A Tornwaldt cyst, also known as a pharyngeal bursa cyst, is a benign, congenital lesion located in the midline of the nasopharynx. It results from persistent communication between the notochord and the nasopharyngeal ectoderm during embryogenesis, forming a residual cavity that may become cystic. On MRI, a Tornwaldt cyst appears as a well-defined, round or oval midline lesion in the posterior nasopharyngeal wall, just superior to the adenoids and inferior to the clivus. It typically shows high signal intensity on T2-weighted images, variable signal on T1, depending on protein or mucus content. No enhancement after contrast administration, although rim enhancement may be seen if inflamed or infected. No diffusion restriction unless superinfected. On CT, the lesion appears as a low attenuation, non-enhancing midline cyst in the nasopharynx. Bone structures are typically intact. When evaluating a midline or paramidline lesion in the nasopharynx, consider the following differentials. Retention cysts of the pharyngeal mucosa, usually more lateral. Nasopharyngeal carcinoma, typically irregular, solid, and enhancing. Craniopharyngeal canal remnants or Rafke cleft cyst, but usually not in the same location. Adenoidal hypertrophy with central necrosis. Correct identification of a Tornwaldt cyst helps prevent misinterpretation as a mass or tumor, particularly in oncologic surveillance studies. The cyst arises from embryological remnants, specifically a persistent communication between the notochord and the nasopharyngeal mucosa. This tract, the pharyngeal bursa, can remain patent and lead to cyst formation, particularly when obstructed or inflamed. Most Tornwaldt cysts are asymptomatic and discovered incidentally during imaging for other reasons. When symptomatic, patients may report postnasal drip, nasal obstruction, occipital headaches, halitosis, recurrent upper respiratory infections if infected. Surgical intervention is rarely needed unless the cyst becomes symptomatic or secondarily infected. If you're interested in learning more about anatomic variants in the sinonasal region, I invite you to watch my video on Haller cells, another relevant topic in head and neck radiology. I've left the link to that video in the comments section below. Don't miss it. Thank you for watching. I hope this video helped clarify the radiologic appearance and clinical relevance of Tornwaldt cysts. If you found this content useful, please consider subscribing to Dr. Martin, Head and Neck Radiology, for more case-based and anatomy-focused radiology content. Your support helps us grow and share knowledge with the global radiology community. See you in the next video.